It's a game. It works. And I didn't have to write a single line of code. I let ChatGPT write a whole game for me on Python with one rule. I can't write a single line of code. I just need to give ChatGPT instructions. It needs to output a script. I copy and paste that script onto my IDE called Spider. The script needs to run and produce a game. So pretending that I know nothing, which may not be too much of a pretend, I asked ChatGPT this. I want to create a game on Python. And it responded. It told me it's a great idea, which I feel pretty good about. And then it gave me some steps. What tools I need to install, what basics I need to learn. We will not be learning anything in this video. We will just be copying and pasting. Absolutely no learning will be done at all. So, to save some time, I didn't read the rest of the response and I just asked it the question, what is the easiest way to create a game on Python? Then it gave me quite an essay, which again, I may not have read the whole thing, but basically I needed to choose a library and it suggested Pygame, which is a popular choice. So without reading further, I thought, sweet, let's create a Python game with Pygame, which led to this prompt. Can you create a Pygame script for me? Now, this is where it starts getting juicy because it asked me questions in order for it to write the script. Number one was what type of game do I want to create? And it gave me options for a platformer, a shooter game, a puzzle, etc. The second question was, what are the basic mechanics of the game? Example, how does a player move? What are the win and lose conditions? And the last question was, do you have any specific requirements or features that I want in the game? And I thought long and hard about the game that I was going to develop. Okay, so my game is where we have a basket at the bottom of the screen and apples falling from the top of the screen. The basket height doesn't change, but the user can move the basket left and right to catch the apples falling. Once the user gets 10 apples in the basket, the user wins. So I submitted that description hoping that would be enough. And it gave me a script, so looks like it was happy with that description. Without even looking, I copied and pasted it into my IDE Spider and ran the script. So the first draft is actually looking good. We have a working game. I have a basket, which is represented by a blue line at the bottom, followed by apples, which are represented by red squares. Now, I only had one issue other than the game aesthetic, but the issue was that when I tried to move the basket left and right, I had to press the keyboard too many times and the basket just didn't move fast enough. So I told ChatGPT, the basket doesn't move fast enough. And it actually gave me a good response. It said that there are two ways to fix this. Method one was that I increase the basket speed from 5 to 10. Or method two is to adjust the speed of the basket based on how long the arrow key is pressed. Now, I preferred method two because that means that I don't need to smash my keyboard 1,000 times. And the concept works that if you long press the left or right keys, the basket just moves faster. So I chose method two, and then it gave me the script for method two. I copied it into my IDE and clicked run. Immediately, the basket moves much better. All I need to do is just long press the key. It moves faster and then the usability is just more natural. But the game itself looks pretty bad. So let's fix that. So the next thing I did was I asked ChatGPT, what if I wanted to add a picture as a basket? And ChatGPT then outputted a modified code which now uses an image as a basket instead of that ugly blue line. So I just looked through the script and it looks like it references something called basket.png. Now I assume that image needs to be put into the same folder as where my script is. That's just how Python works. And it needs to be called basket.png. So I created a basket picture on Canva. I downloaded it and added it to my folder and I ran the script. Okay, so now this basket is looking huge. So let's make it smaller. I went back to Canva. I edited the size of the basket, so made it a lot more smaller. I then removed the old basket picture, added my new basket picture to the folder, and ran the script again. Okay, so this is looking good. I now have the basket as an image. It moves fine. It looks pretty good. So let's change the apples. Again, the same process here. I went to Canva. I created an apple image. I made it the same size as a basket because I learned from my mistake. I downloaded the apples picture. I then asked ChatGPT, what if I wanted to use an image as an apple? And now it gave me the updated script. So the script looks like it references apple.png. I've taken my Apple picture, I've added it to my folder and called it apple.png. I've run the script and this is what I get. Awesome. So I have apples that look like apples and I have a basket that looks like a basket. Much better. The only thing that's left is maybe changing the background image. Something like this, which I created on Canva, with a width of 800 and a height of 600. And again, I just asked ChatGPT, what if I wanted to use an image for the background? And it gave me another modified script. Such hard work. I added my background image to the folder and I ran the script one last time. And I have a game that works with graphics and I didn't write a single line of code. This is pretty impressive to do without even telling ChatGPT anything technical at all. I was able to create a full game in a matter of minutes, no code at all.